Today's material is on confidence intervals for variances and standard deviation. So we're still doing confidence intervals. But this time it's for the variance and standard deviation. So we'll do both with the same distribution. Okay, so we have a completely new distribution that we want to talk about today, and it's referred to, it's called the chi-square distribution. And this is how we spell it, C-H-I, but it's pronounced chi-square. And the symbol for it looks like this, chi-square. It is a family of curves distribution, so like the t-distribution, there's not just one curve that fits all, it's a family. So you'll notice that when we look at the table, you'll go down to a certain degrees of freedom depending on your sample size. Okay? What you do need to know is, again, so it could be many curves, you could have something like that, whatever. Okay, depending on sample size, you'll have a little different curve that you're looking at. For today's material, the degrees of freedom, similar to the t-distribution. What was the degrees of freedom for t-distribution last time?
N minus one,
yeah. So it's still that today for the chi-square distribution for confidence interval for variance and standard deviation. Okay, if you guys take a look at your chart for a second, if you just look at it, one thing, if you look at the bottom right corner, one thing that you want to notice right away is how the chart is read, okay? And in particular, the chi-square distribution, it gives you area in the right tail, okay? So the way we read that chart, if you look at the bottom, is it gives you area to the right, all right? And then, you know, like with the z-distribution, we had z-values. With the t-distribution, we had t-values. But with the chi-square distribution, you have chi-square values, okay? So we have chi-square values, and when we read the chart, it gives area to the right. So please make sure you see, when you're trying to look it up, you're looking area to the right. Okay, so before we jump into the formula, I want to examine how you find chi-square values. Okay, so with each confidence interval, you guys are going to find a chi-squared right value and a chi-squared left value. So let's draw a picture here. Put some area here, some area here. We're going to call this guy chi squared right, and this guy chi squared left. All right, so those are the values that you're going to have to find using your chart. Okay, let's do a practice example just to go through how it works. So let's say we're going to find a 95% confidence interval. Okay, so my confidence level is 95%. And let's say my sample size is 30. Okay? And then all I want you to be able to do is tell me what chi-squared right has to be and what chi-squared left has to be for this setup. Okay, so we go through all the steps that we've been going through whenever we did any confidence interval. If I have 95%, that is the middle area, right? So this middle area is 0.95, just like all the previous confidence intervals. So how much is left for alpha? How much area do I have total in each tail then? 5%, right, at 0.05. So if I split that up in the half, we have 0.025 here, and we have 0.025 here. Does everybody agree with that? Okay, very similar to the stuff that we've been doing. If my n is 30, what is my degrees of freedom? N minus 1, which is 29. Okay. Now here is, you know, it's potentially a little tricky. I want to find this value based on this picture, okay? So if my book or my chart gives me area to the right, what area is to the right of this value? Well, it's sitting right here, right? 0.025. So everybody with me? So the first value that we want to go try to find is you want to look at 0.025, and then we want to go down to 29 degrees of freedom. And that will give me my chi-squared right value for this picture, okay? So across the very top of your chart, you're going to go to 0.025. And then we can go down to 29 degrees of freedom. And we're going to read off that value. And hopefully everybody sees that it's 45.722. Okay. So this value here is 45.722. That's my chi-squared right value. Okay? And that was relatively easy because, again, my book is set up giving you right area. So 0.025, I just looked up 0.025. All right, now when I want to look up chi-squared left, and I want to use this chart, what area is to the right of this value? Right? Again, our book is set up area to the right. If the area to the left is 0.025, then what is the area to the right of it? Everything has to add up to 100%, right? So if this little area is 0.025, what is everything else going to add up to?
1 minus 0.025,
which is 0.975. Everybody see that?
Yeah.
So to look this value up, I need to look at the area to the right of it, and that's going to be 0.975. So you go to your book, you go across the chart, you look at 0.975 across the top, and then again go down to 29 degrees of freedom, and you should get 16.047. So this value is 16.047. And you guys are going to have to do that every single time to use the actual complements interval formula, because chi-squared right and chi-squared left are in the formula. Okay? So treat it just like you've been doing all the confidence intervals. Whatever your confidence level is, put that in the middle, figure out what area you have in the tails. This area is easy. You just look up that value because it's area to the right. This area, you're going to have to do 1 minus to the left, because our book is set up to give area to the right, okay? And then just go down to the correct degrees of freedom, and that will give you your chi-squared right and chi-squared left pi. Okay, let me now put up the formula for the variance and standard deviation confidence interval. All right, so here is my confidence interval for our variance. It's n minus 1 times s squared divided by chi squared right. That's the lower bound, comma, the upper bound is n minus 1 times s squared divided by chi squared left. Okay? This is your confidence interval for our variance. So this is my variance, confidence interval. Here's my lower bound, here's my upper bound, and the degrees of freedom is n minus 1. Okay? Now, if this is my confidence interval for a variance, what do you guys think my confidence interval for a standard deviation is going to be?
Square root
of it, exactly. Okay, so for the standard deviation, it's the same formula, but you're going to have a square root. So n minus 1, parentheses s squared, over chi squared left, comma, and a big square root. N minus 1 over times s squared over chi squared, chi squared left should be here, and chi squared right should be here. Okay, and of course the degrees of freedom is still the same, n minus 1. So, it's all about identify chi-squared right, chi-squared left, and then this other stuff has to be given in the problem, right? I need to know how big the sample is, and I need to know what s squared is, okay? Now, one thing that can potentially be tricky is s squared. What does s squared stand for again? What is s squared? That is your sample variance, right? So if they give you the sample variance is this, s squared is that, okay? But sometimes they're going to say the standard deviation is this, and that's just s. So sometimes you're going to have to square it, and sometimes you're not going to have to square it, depending on what is given in the problem. If they give you variance, that is s squared. You don't have to square it. If they give you standard deviation, then that's just s, and then you're going to have to square it in the formula. Okay, does that make sense? So they could give you either or. They could give you s, or they could give you s squared. So that's one potential trick that you might run into. Okay, great. Let's do an example or two. All right, here we go. Find the 99% confidence interval for the variance and standard deviation of the weights of containers of motor oil if a sample of 14 containers had a variance of 3.2. Okay, so here's a question. Example one. We're trying to find a 99% confidence interval for the variance and standard deviation. So we're asked for both. Of the weights of containers of motor oil. Weights of containers of motor oil. And we're given that a sample of 14 had a variance of 3.2. Okay, and it says assume the variable is normally distributed. We need that assumption to be able to do these problems. All right, so we have to do both. We're asked for the variance and standard deviation confidence interval. Okay, so my first recommendation to you is we're doing a 99%. I need to figure out what chi-squared right and chi-squared left is. So that should be your first thing. All right, let's figure out chi-squared right and chi-squared left. For 99%. Okay, so go ahead and start trying that on your own. We're going to draw the chi-squared picture. Distribution looks a little different, something like that. You're going to have 99% in the middle, which means there is a total area of only 0.01 total for the tails. So if this is only 0.01 and this is only 0.01 total, you can split it up, it's 0.005. 0.005. Okay? What's the degrees of freedom on this problem?
13.
So right now, you should go into the table in your book, and you need to find 13 degrees of freedom and area 0.005, and that will give you your chi-squared right value. So 0.005, 13 degrees of freedom, and what do you guys get for that value?
29.819.
Yes, 29.819. Perfect. So chi-squared right is 29.819. Okay, now let's look at chi-squared left. I go to my book again. The area to the left is 0.005, but my book is set up to read area to the right. So I need to look at 0.995 and then go down to 13 degrees of freedom. So go to 0.995, it's the far left column. Go down to 13 degrees of freedom, and you get 3.565. So over here, 3.565. Okay, that's the meat of the problem, just figuring out chi-squared right and chi-squared left. Now let's go into my big confidence interval formulas. So let's do variance first. Okay. So it's what?
13 times 3.2.
N minus 1 times S squared. Variance is S squared. So you just leave it at 3.2. Divided by chi squared. Which one?
Right.
Right. So 29.819. Okay. That is my lower left bound. And then my right bound is going to be the same thing in the top. 13 times 3.2. But then divided by chi-squared left, 3.565. Okay, so take that to your calculator, and let's take this out to four decimal places. And let's see what we get here. 13 times 3.2 divided by 29.819. Four decimal places, I'm getting 1.3951, approximately 1.3951, comma. Then your upper bound is going to be 13 times 3.2 divided by 3.565, 11.6690. Okay, so that's my confidence interval for the variance. And then pretty much we're finished now. To get my standard deviation, I simply have to do what? So do the square root of these two values, right? So I'll just put it up here since I'm running out of room. And let's go to three decimal places again. So I'm putting in the actual original values and then square root in it. So 1.1811, and then the square root of the other one, 13 times 3.2 divided by 3.565 square roots, 3.4160, and we're finished. Okay, so there's a couple of new things. We have to get comfortable using the chi-square distribution. The way you do the setup is still the same. You put the confidence level in the middle, the area in the tails, split that in half, okay? This right value, chi-squared right, is pretty easy. You just look it up in the table. The chi-squared left value, you have to subtract this area from 1, because my book is set up to read to the right, okay? Go down to n minus 1 degrees of freedom, and that gives you your chi-squared right and chi-squared left value, which is the denominator of your formula. Then the other part of your formula is just n minus 1 times s squared. So be very careful with this s squared. Sometimes in the problems, they will give you variance, and you just leave it at 3.2. But sometimes it will say the standard deviation is blah, 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 and then you'll have to square that in your problem. Okay? Questions on the confidence interval for the variance and the standard deviation? Great.